Say it again.
After Miracle. Thank you. Thank you for your question. Should we post a picture? You want? Oh, see, now everyone wants to pose for a picture. Quick, stand there. How old are you?
16.
16. There you go. Did you get it? Whoever get it. Thank you very much for your question. Hi.
Hi.
I'm going to sit down here on the table. Oh, it's cold. How old are you?
12.
12. How old are you?
Just turned 18 a couple weeks ago.
So are you a guardian to him?
Technically, I'm his older sibling, so.
Your older sibling at 18.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you brought him here at 12.
My,
I love both of you. Where are your parents?
They're back there.
Where are they? So you're cool? Great, okay. I love families that are progressive. Any questions you have about anything that's discussed, you make sure you talk to your mom and your dad. You don't ask on the playground. Exactly. He's like, shut up, whatever. They don't have a playground in his school?
It's junior high. They don't have a playground in my old junior high.
So where do you go outside at school?
Gym.
They don't. The gym?
They go outside for gym when they have to run laps sometimes.
Right.
I don't go outside anymore because I'm a senior now. I don't
have gym. Oh yeah, you're too cool to like go outside and do any of that, right?
Fine arts classes, I'm very cool.
I know, thank you. And what fine arts classes are you taking?
I'm in varsity choir, I'm in junior varsity orchestra, and I'm in art one.
Are you good at math?
I don't take a math class anymore, but I have 5 math credits, so.
That's good, because you know music is math.
Mm-hmm. It is. Like we're playing a piece in 12-8, I think, right now?
Can you count in 12-8?
Yes. It's the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Very good. She did the hand gesture. The proper one. What's your question?
Well, I actually just came up here to get him. I want to compliment you on the dress, by the way. It looks amazing.
Thank you. I know it's personally made. It cost a frickin' fortune. Yeah, because these are all Swarovski crystals. Yeah. Yeah. You can get an L. Hoffer Design online, who do all my cosplays. You can order them. You can get them at a lesser cost. But if you want the fabulous John Barrowman one, you better start working. Or remortgage your house. Because trust me, I'm still paying for this one. So it's his question.
It's his question.
So what is your name?
Ree,
and your name is?
Alistair.
Alistair, great names. So what's your question, Alistair?
What is your favorite food?
Alistair, that's the most refreshing question I have been asked in a long time. My favorite food, I don't have one particular favorite food. However, if you were to come over to my house and it were about 6 o'clock in the evening on a Friday or Saturday, and Scott and I were sitting down for what we call cocktail hour and having a little bit of a drink along with some snacks, Scott would eat a bag of Cheetos. I kid you not, not the little bag, the big bag. He'd sit and eat a bag of Cheetos and have a vodka tonic, and I would have, you know those, they're like, the Doritos lime flavored Doritos? What? Vaguely you know them? Okay. Okay, that's good. Don't eat a lot of chips. That's good. This is about me, not about you. So I would eat those, but my favorite thing in the whole wide world, and I love it, Dean's dip. Do you know Dean's dip? Go to the supermarket and get some Dean's dip. It is like eating plastic. Plastic with flavor. Put it on chips. It's absolutely delicious. And with a vodka soda when you're 21, amazing. I want you all to post pictures to me of you with Dean's dip. Traditional French onion Dean's dip. Whatever you do with it, go ahead. Dip anything in it. Rub it anywhere. But make sure you're 18 or over. Put it on a potato chip. Dean's dip. What's your favorite food? No, nothing. Everyone's, what's your favorite food?
I like fettuccine alfredo with chicken.
Okay, fancy. I'm coming to your house. Do your parents cook that?
Sometimes.
Sometimes. Get with it, Mom and Dad. Is your dad the cook? Is he good?
He's good. He makes a really good chili. We had some this week.
Really?
It was great.
Was it?
Was it meat chili or veggie chili?
Meat chili.
Meat chili. I forget. We're in Texas, right? Yeah. If someone gives me veggie chili in Texas, I'm like, piss off. Have you thought of a favorite food yet?
Taco.
Taco! Oh, yeah. Taco's pretty good. Yeah. I had a taco last night. I had a pulled pork taco with cabbage, onion, and cilantro after I sang the national anthem because I didn't want to be burping or farting when I was singing the national anthem. And I dribbled it all down my shirt. And when I went to my hotel room and I took my shirt off to go to bed, do you know what I did? I licked it. Nasty. Thanks for your question, guys. Thank you. Yeah, thank you. We have 5 minutes. I'm going to do these last two questions. Sorry, everybody. But you want me to sing for you?
Yeah!
Okay, question, sir.
It's about Dr. Who.
Go ahead.
How did you become the face of Bo?
They chopped my head off and stuck me in a bucket, a glass bucket. That's how I became the face of Bo. I have no idea how it happens. We are looking into it in one of the, I think, the stories we're doing for Big Finish coming up. We're gonna start delving into it, and Russell said that's okay to do that. So, yeah, who knows?
Bo.
One of the best moments in the history of Doctor Who. David Tennant and I were watching the episode together, and we were having pizza. And I walked over to my window during the commercial break, and he said, what are you doing? I said, I'm opening the window, David. And he said, why? I said, so I can hear the nation's jaw drop. All right, sweetheart. I heard you playing with your Sonic. Yeah. Oh, it's the new one! Spins and everything. What's your question? Marla?
Marla Dean, nice to meet you. What's your question, sweet?
What is it now? Is there any chance you'll ride in the TARDIS with the new doctor?
I have no idea. It's not up to me again. That's a thing that's up to Chris Chibnall and up to, you know, the showrunner. However, I remember Russell T. Davis saying something a long time ago. He said, we're not, and it's, I know the fans would love Jack to be back, but he said, we're writing it not just for the old fans, we're writing it for new fans. So they have to keep moving the show forward. That doesn't mean I wouldn't love that they did a little homage to him or brought him back, like, you know, he bumps into himself or whatever. I don't know. We'll see. But I know that the reaction, he would be like, well, I can work with that. Exactly. Wait till you see my cosplay coming up next year. Might be just something like this. There you go, sweetheart. Thank you, Marla. Appreciate it. Big round of applause before I forget for our signer for today. You manage back okay, sweetheart? Yeah, good. So, I thought just like a nice subdued song, would that be okay?
Great.
Yeah.
So, this is a song that when I was, if you guys want to get back to your seats so everybody behind you can still see. Scott and I went, marriage equality passed, and we went the very day that it passed to the registrar's office to get married because we could finally. And we went and did it immediately, and we were in shorts and a t-shirt, and we got to the registrar's office, and there was a lot of people there, about 200 people, and they were, you know, all aged from about, not kidding, 65 to 80 years old. And we got there, and it was easy to get to the front of the line, because we could run, and they were all, you know. So we got to the front, and we were married, and we were really happy, and it was awesome, and we turned around, and a guy came up to us, and he said, Mr. Barrowman, we all know who you are. We don't have a lot of family members left. Some of us are by ourselves with our partners, and we don't have anyone to witness our marriage. Could you and your husband be our witness? And I looked at Scott, and I said, it's going to be a long day. So we did. We witnessed a lot of other marriages of men, women, and even, you know, men and women all getting married on that particular day. We had a great time. We videoed a lot of stuff. And when we were finished, one gentleman came up to us and he introduced himself and he said, "Thank you for doing that." He said, "My name is Tom." And he said, "I'm 84 years old." And he said, "My husband is Bill and he is 82 years old. And he said, "This is the biggest day of our lives because we don't have any family to witness this. However, we never thought we would be alive to ever see the day that we could celebrate our love for each other without being judged or having any of this ever happen. We thought we would be dead before any of this came into fruition." And I went, "Oh my God, I have to record a song about this day." So I said thank you to everybody, and I went back and I went and recorded this song because the words, however, might mean something different to other people, but for me, nobody should tell you how long you should wait to be able to find the person that you fall in love with. No one should tell you how you fall in love, who you fall in love with. Everybody should just let each other love each other, and that's the way it should be. And this is called A Thousand Years, so hit it. Heart beats fast, colors and promises. How to be brave? How can I love when I'm afraid to fall? Watching you stand alone, all of my doubt suddenly goes away.
Everybody love!